Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins.
Lord, you heal sick of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you set sinners free. Christ, have mercy. Lord, you are seated at the right hand of the Father interceding for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to the people of your will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The seed that falls on the ground will yield a fruitful harvest. harvest.
The fields are garlanded with flocks, and the valleys blanketed with rain. They shout and sing for joy.
The seed that falls on the ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed before us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains, even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we await for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Some fell on rocky ground where it had little soil. It sprang up at once because the soil was not deep. And when the sun rose, it was scorched and it withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. And some seeds fell on rich soil and produced fruit, 100 or 60 or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear. The disciples approached him and said, "Why do you speak to them in parables?" And he said to them in reply, "Because knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven have been granted to you, but to them it has not been granted. To anyone who has more will be given, and he will grow rich. And from anyone who has not, even what he has will be taken away." This is why I speak to them in parables, because they look but do not see and hear, but do not listen or understand. Isaiah's prophecy is fulfilled in them. It says, "You shall indeed hear but not understand. You shall indeed look but never see. Gross is the heart of this people. They will hardly hear with their ears. They have closed their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their hearts, and be converted, and I will heal them. But blessed are you, your eyes, because they see, and your ears, because they hear. Amen, I say to you, many prophets and righteous people long to see what you see but did not see it, and to hear what you hear but did not hear it. Hear the parable of the sower. The seed sown on the path is the one who hears the word of the kingdom without understanding it. And the evil one comes and steals it away. What was sown in their hearts. The seed sown on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and receives it at once with joy, but it has no root and lasts only for a time. And when some tribulation or persecution comes because of the word, he immediately falls away. The seed sown among thorns is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety, lure of riches, choke the word, and it bears no fruit. But the seed sown on rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields 100, 60, or 30-fold. The gospel of the Lord.
It's been said before, if you want something done well, ask a busy man to do it. And I found that to be especially true during this time. The last few months, there's been a lull in the amount of work that most of us have had to do. And I found myself asking Deacon Pat to read the longer version of the gospel rather than the shorter version, not because we get to hear more of the word of God, but simply because I'd have to do less preaching. Just kidding about that. But the reality is, I could actually sit down right now and not even preach a homily because Jesus did my job for me. Because the longer version is basically going into detail, Jesus going into detail and explaining what is meant by the parable of the sower and the seed. I can remember when I was in the seminary, one of the things that I learned very early on from a philosopher and a theologian called St. Justin Martyr. He lived around the year 170 or 190, something like that. Very, very early on in the church. And Justin Martyr was one of the first saints, one of the first people to try to show how grace coincides with or builds upon nature, right? I love how Jesus, whenever he preaches, usually something in the Gospels, he uses things of our world, things that we're very familiar with, but he takes it a step further so that we might explore a little bit more deeply the mystery behind it, or the truth behind just the superficial statement. The thing that was said by St. Justin Martyr was this, the Latin phrase called logoi spermaticoi, in Latin meaning seeds of the word. You can figure it out for yourself, but logoi, you know, from logos. So the seeds of the word, what Justin Martyr was saying is that the seeds of Jesus Christ, the seeds of truth, are to be found everywhere in this world. Even on rocky, dirty, unfertilized soil, the seeds of truth are sown by God. And as we hear in the first reading, God's word will not return fruitless. Favorite quote of mine from the movie Jurassic Park is when one of the doctors played by it's one of the details that it's the nerding out of glasses. There you go. Thank you. Okay, I preached this homily yesterday and I remembered it like that. It's just one of the things I forgot in the morning. So anyway, if I'm gonna forget one thing, it might as well be that, right? Okay. So anyway, he's the mathematician character. He's talking about life, and he's saying that life will push through any boundaries. Life will not be held back. Life always finds a way. And this is precisely what God's Word does. God's Word finds a way. You and I, even though we are born and we are into a society that is not conducive to receiving the Word of God, our society is not conducive. Our world right now is not conducive. When I talk about the world, I'm not talking about the natural world that God creates, but the corruption of the world caused by man and by the evil one. We're not living in a time that's conducive for the Word to bear fruit. But yet that doesn't stop God, because as St. Paul says, where sin abounds, grace abounds all the more. We may find ourselves in a wasteland, and everywhere we look is a desert. But the Lord Jesus gives us the tools to cultivate and fertilize the garden in our hearts so that we can receive God's Word, and it will bear fruit, not just in our lives, but in the lives of those who we love, and in the lives of those with whom we come into contact with. The Word of God will always find a way, just like life will always find a way. The seeds of the Word are all around us. Do we have the eyes of faith to recognize the signs of the times and the seeds of the truth and love of Jesus Christ in our midst? And are we willing to put the effort and the work in, and a little bit of sweat, to cultivate our soil? Because if we don't put the effort into it, it's not going to happen. Coming to Mass 1 hour a week is not enough. Jesus Christ is there to help us to till the soil and to prepare it to receive the Word of Jesus Christ so that it can bear fruit.
Of
hope, joy, and compassion, we pray to the Lord. For Bishop Parks' brother, Bishop-elect Stephen Parks, in the Diocese of Savannah, that the Holy Spirit will guide him in this new appointment, we pray to the Lord. For peace among all nations, for God's word to bring an end to violence, for healing and reconciliation, we pray to the Lord. For all who close their hearts to God's word, for God to break through their barriers for healing and reconciliation, we pray to the Lord. For all gathered here, for freedom from the cares and anxieties that enslave our hearts, for allowing God's word to empower us to live in freedom as God's children, we pray to the Lord. For all the young people who received the sacraments yesterday, that the Holy Spirit will continue to guide them and protect them in their life's journey, we pray to the Lord. For those who are ill, especially those with the coronavirus, for the Lord's guidance to bring an end to the pandemic, and for those who have asked us to pray for them, especially for Roger Rolowitz, Loretta Spires, Catherine Tonelli, Mark David McAvoy, and Cecilio Sintron. For God's love, peace, and healing, we pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially Don Sheely, Harold Rulison, Columbia Alwalto, Rhoda Lubas, Lorene Voss, and Michael Brown, for God's gift of eternal life, we pray to the Lord. And for Elizabeth Ann Kirkow, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. And for those intentions that we hold in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord God, you promise your word will achieve the end for which you sent it. May we strive to hear you more clearly and continue to remain faithful to your call of service. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as a joyful celebration we acclaim.
Saints who have pleased you throughout the ages,
may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Let's take a few moments of silence and ask God to help our hearts to be more fertile to receive the word. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
There's announcement, a misprint in one of the local papers. I can't read it. One of the Observer papers says that Mass is canceled here. Obviously it's not. So don't pay attention to this. And then don't forget to register for our faith formation classes coming up. Also, we need to continue to bear in mind our sisters and brothers at home who are still not able to join us for Mass. And so with that in mind, we'll say the act of spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you as my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
quick thing. The quote that I mentioned, "Life will find a way," is actually not my favorite Jurassic Park quote. My favorite Jurassic Park quote is "Clever girl," but I couldn't figure out a way to work that in Hollywood, so. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, the glorious, we live the gospel.